Hi friends, I am Dr. Chaudhary. I welcome you all to this video, analytic functions. In this video, I would like to explain this problem, how to find the bilinear transformation of the following problem. See this question. Find the bilinear transformation that maps the points z equal to 0, minus 1, I onto the points w equal to I, 0, infinity respectively. Also find the image of modulus z less than or equal to 1 under this transformation. Now, what we are going to do? We are going to find the bilinear transformation through the points. Also, we find the image of unit circle which is lies inside the region. Given points in W plane, I, 0, infinity. In Z plane, 0, minus 1, I. Let us consider the points W1 equal to I, W2 equal to 0, W3 equal to infinity. Note this one, here W3 value equal to infinity. And in Z plane, Z1 equal to 0, Z2 equal to minus 1, and Z3 equal to I. Now we are going to use the cross ratio property of bilinear transformation. That is, the cross ratio of 4 points is invariant under a bilinear transformation. Therefore, the 4th point in Z plane is Z, and the 4th point in W plane is W. That is, W, W1, W2, W3 are the images of Z, Z1, Z2, Z3. Respectively. Already we said invariant, therefore the image of Z is W under this transformation. Now the formula W minus W1 divided by W minus W3 into W2 minus W3 divided by W2 minus W1. As per the invariant condition, right answer comes Z minus Z1 divided by Z minus Z3 into Z2 minus Z3 divided by Z2 minus Z1. Now, the easy way to remember the formula. See the numerator 1, 2, 3, denominator 3, 2, 1. Now, don't think that this is the one and only formula for bilinear transformation. Sometimes we modify the formula in order to the given points. Here, W3 equal to infinity. So, practically, we couldn't apply directly in this formula. So, we are going to modify the formula. Take W3 from numerator outside and W3 from denominator. Right answer as it is. Here W3 equal to only one value. So we can easily cancel W3 from numerator and denominator. After cancelling W3 from numerator and denominator, it comes W minus W1 into W2 divided by W3 minus 1 divided by W by W3 minus 1 into W2 minus W1. Right hand side as it is. Now we are going to substitute the values W1 equal to I, W2 equal to 0, W3 equal to infinity, and Z1 equal to 0, Z2 equal to minus 1, Z3 equal to I. W minus I into 0 by W3. Here I didn't apply W3 equal to infinity since numerator is 0. So 0 by anything 0. So we know to apply W3 value divided by W by infinity minus 1 into 0 minus I equal to Z minus 0 divided by Z minus I into minus 1 minus I divided by minus 1 minus 0. Now we know that any value by infinity equal to 0. Applying the above condition, we got this result. Now, we may simplify the left hand side. W minus I into minus 1 divided by minus 1 into minus I. Now, see the right hand side. Take minus 1 common from the numerator. Therefore, minus Z into 1 plus I divided by Z minus I into minus 1. Now, cancelling all the minus from left hand side and right hand side, we can get W minus I divided by minus I equal to Z into 1 plus I divided by Z minus I. Now, we bring this minus I to right hand side. Therefore, right hand side comes Z into minus I minus I square divided by Z minus I. Here, minus I square value equal to plus 1. Now, from left hand side, minus I bring to right hand side as plus I. Now, we are going to take LCM. Therefore, LCM is Z minus I. Therefore, the numerator minus I is plus Z plus zi minus I square. Here minus I square value equal to plus 1. After applying minus I square value equal to plus 1, W change to this form. Look at the numerator. Minus IZ plus ZI. Both will be cancelled. Therefore, W equal to Z plus 1 divided by Z minus I. This is the required bilinear transformation. Now we are going to complete the second target. Find the image of modulus Z less than or equal to 1. Here, we need to find Z in terms of W. So, we rearrange the transformation. If you want to apply the component and dividend method, adding and subtracting the numerator and denominator, we may get one term is Z term, another term is constant alone. Here, look at the term Z plus 1 and Z minus I. Adding these terms, we may get Z with the constant. Therefore, C and D rule is not applicable. So, best method is cross multiplication method. Now, bring this Z minus to left hand side. W into Z minus I equal to Z plus 1. Now we multiply W inside the bracket. WZ minus WI equal to Z plus 1. Now we club Z term on left hand side. WZ minus Z equal to minus WI comes right hand side. WI plus 1. Now we may take Z common. Z into W minus 1 equal to WI plus 1. Therefore, Z equal to WI plus 1 divided by W minus 1. This is the required transformation for Z in terms of W. Now we are going to apply Z values in this equation. Now, as per the property, the denominator modulus W minus 1 bring to right hand side. Now we are going to apply W value equal to U plus IV both the left hand side and right hand side. Now multiply I inside the bracket. Therefore, modulus I U minus B plus 1 less than or equal to U plus IV minus 1. Now we are keeping real and imaginary parts separately in both left hand side and right hand side. Therefore, modulus 1 minus B plus IU less than or equal to modulus U minus 1 plus IV. By the formula, modulus value of complex number is square root of real part square plus imaginary part square. Now see the left hand side. Real part is 1 minus b and imaginary part is u. Therefore, square root of 1 minus b whole square plus u square. And see the right hand side. Real part is u minus 1 and imaginary part is b. Therefore, less than or equal to square root of u minus 1 whole square plus b square. Squaring on both sides, it comes 1 minus b whole square plus u square less than or equal to u minus 1 whole square plus b square. Now expanding 1 minus b whole square and u minus 1 whole square, it comes 1 plus b square minus 2b plus u square less than or equal to u square minus 2u plus 1 plus b square. Now the common term 1 b square u square will be cancelled. Therefore, minus 2b less than or equal to minus 2u. Cancelling minus 2 on both sides, it comes v greater than or equal to u. Therefore, the image of modulus z less than or equal to 1 is u minus v less than or equal to 0. Now we conclude this problem by diagram. Draw the unit circle in z plane. Now the image of modulus z less than or equal to 1 in w plane is u minus v less than or equal to 0, that is above the portion of u equal to v. By the transformation, w equal to z plus 1 divided by z minus I. Thank you for watching this video. If you have any doubt or if you want to have any explanation for any problem, post in comment. I will explain in some other video.